you hear things like City Killer or a similar asteroid wiped out the dinosaurs, it makes you a little nervous. So please calm us down.
Well, I mean, you should be very calm about this asteroid, 1998 QE2. But we are the first humans, as far as I know, that could do something about an asteroid that had our name on it. As we like to say, we live in a cosmic shooting gallery. You look at the surface of the moon, there's a lot of craters. If you look carefully at the surface of the Earth, there are a lot of craters. And so we don't ever want to get hit by one of these things. So it would be a great thing if the United States, if NASA got very motivated about this, and we worked with our colleagues around the world to develop a system, this would be some sort of spacecraft, that could deflect an asteroid. But the first step in all this is detecting them. And you see how, even with our very best instruments, this image is still blurry, and the moon is squished in the Doppler axis, as it said. And so this is all we could do better with this if we worked at it.
Well, and it's important because we all remember the meteor that hit Russia. But if you folks out there don't remember, I want to remind you. Here's the sonic boom. Okay, so that was really scary, and that asteroid was much smaller, and it broke apart as it entered the Earth's atmosphere. Scientists actually did not see that one coming, so why can they see this latest one, and why didn't they see that one?
Well, that one was, estimates are varied, but about 14 meters across, barely from home plate to the pitching mound. But this asteroid is it's 3 kilometers across. It's, you know, well over a mile, mile and a half across. So it's a much bigger thing. And you can see it and see it with radar. So what we are hoping to do today about, I guess 5 p.m. Eastern, 2 p.m. Pacific time, it'll come close enough with people with telescopes who are very skilled, be able to get a better look at it.
Oh.
And this thing is one of hundreds of thousands of these objects that are about the same distance from the sun as we are, and many of them cross the Earth's orbit, and we know a very small percentage of them. And so it's an opportunity for space agencies and amateur astronomers around the world to work together to perhaps, and I'm not kidding, save the world, at least save the world for us humans.